we have another brand new technical innovation here in 8H. Our director, Hal Gurney, has been hard at work coming up with something we call the Thrill Cam. This is the step beyond the late night Sky Cam. We have the late night Monkey Cam, the Guest Cam. Tonight we're going to be inaugurating the Thrill Cam. Hal, go ahead and show the folks how that works exactly. Okay, it's the Thrill Cam. Watch closely. There it goes. This is better than real TV, isn't it? my first guest tonight is... the gears are encased in a soundproof box. My first guest tonight is the only person whose likeness we've ever allowed to appear on a piece of official late-night clothing. Here it is right here. This is Connie Chung on her fourth anniversary special. She is the anchor, along with Roger Mudd, of the wildly successful, brand-new NBC News magazine program called 1986, and certainly a lovely woman. Please say hello once again to Connie Chung. Connie... Congratulations, the show did very well, didn't it, in its premiere week?
It really did.
When was it on? First time? Last week was the first week?
Last Tuesday, when you were on vacation.
And what things were on the show?
Well, let's see,
I saw a piece on Mary Martin.
Yes, yeah. Roger Mudd had a marvelous, really charming interview with Mary Martin.
Yeah. And then something about pickup trucks exploding?
Yeah, that was my story.
That was your story?
Yeah, and then a story called Sell or Else, these teenage kids who are sucked in by these groups and... They have to sell magazines or soap detergent or whatever, and they're kept, they're actually held in hotels and unable to call their parents.
Really? Now, how can that happen? I guess it doesn't happen anymore because you've blown the lid on this.
Well, no, actually, we received a lot of calls later. Really, a mother who was concerned because she hadn't heard from her son, and he began...
Turned out he was off selling magazines. is that how that works?
Yeah. I mean, they're actually brought in. You know, and then we also had a story on... the porous borders, how easy it is to get anything from drugs or whatever into the country, terrorism, whatever. How easy it could be.
So much for that vote of confidence, ladies and gentlemen.
David, I want to ask you
What?
You know, and this is something I've been meaning to ask you.
Did you see the lovely plants we got from Phil Donahue?
I saw you got them from Donahue, yeah.
Phil sent them over.
That's great. Yeah. the other day, no. I was thinking, it was a long time ago that I kept meaning to ask you. Remember when you used to do Carson, when you used to substitute for Carson, and you used to take your tooth out?
Yeah, I took it out once.
You did?
Yeah.
What happened to that?
I've got it in now.
You do?
Yeah.
Do you still have it?
I have it right there. It's right in there.
Is that the one?
That's the one.
Remember when the audience used to
What are you getting to,
out,
Connie? You want me to take it out? Limits, and I can't be pushed into that kind of humiliation. It's just a little plastic thing you put in your mouth. There it is. There's the damn tooth. Right there. So, are you happy now, Big Shot? Anything come out of your mouth, Connie? Like working a rodeo, isn't it? Now, Connie, did you ever get your contract deal settled with NBC? Because you were very close, I know, to going to CNN or something, weren't you?
Yeah, but not CNN.
Your contract?
Uh-huh.
So how many years are you going to be here?
Three.
And a big, huge contract?
It's just fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you're quite comfortable with the contract, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Now, how close were you actually to leaving NBC? And I think it would have been a loss for the organization.
Well, not. I mean, I... No, I mean, I seriously thought about
it. Where did you want to go? CBS. They wanted you over there at CBS to take Rather's job, didn't they?
No. No, David, no. No, but I really... No, I really loved it here, and so, I wanted to stay.
Yeah, and so you are staying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tell me the truth later.
Okay.
Johnny, we had this, we had your picture on a, and we're going to give it to you tonight, because before, you
really?
Made such a stink about it.
Oh,
and,
my gosh.
And I've had this for about 6 months.
Really gonna...
I'm going to give it to you. And I've
really?
Had it for 6 months, and I haven't worn it once. And I figured if I haven't worn it once in 6 months, will I ever wear it? Of course, the answer is no. It's yours.
Really? Oh, gosh.
Yeah. Yeah. Huh? What? No, let's... Well, we'll be right back here with Johnny Chung. It looks very nice on you. We have a great show tonight. Connie Chung is here from NBC News, one of the anchors of 1986. And also on the weekends, you're going to be doing nightly news on
Saturday night.
Who does it on Sunday nights? Is it on Sunday
night? Chris Wallace.
Chris Wallace. Oh, he's very good also.
He's terrific.
Now, your husband, tell him who your husband is.
His name is Maury Povich, and he does the news in Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm. How long have you been married to Maury?
About a year and a half, I guess.
Really? Uh-huh. But you've known him for a long time, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Where'd you meet Maury?
I guess in Washington years and years ago.
Do you call him Maury around the house?
Yeah. It's Maury, M-A-U-R-Y, as opposed to Maury.
See, I have the trouble with other people on the staff. We have a lot of Laurys and a lot of Laurys on the show. And I don't know the difference between L-O-R-I and L-A-U-R-I-E. But it's Maury. Maury is Maury.
Maury, right.
Maury, okay. Uh-huh. And so what do you call him when you're not calling him Maury? Do you call him Mo?
Well, Mopo. His last name is Povich, so it's Lopo.
Yeah.
Some people call him Mopo.
He's also the son of a very famous sports writer.
Yeah. Washington
Shirley
Post.
Povich.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you call him?
Dad.
Yeah, well, that makes perfect sense. Now, he's going to get a show of his own.
Yes.
Yeah.
I had worked...
Was this in your contract?
No. I had worked so hard to get myself to Washington because we have a commuter marriage. I live in New York.
Yeah.
He's from Washington.
Are you originally from Washington?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Born and raised there. And he...
I think it's born and reared there, actually.
Maybe for you. No.
Well. Okay, so you were born and raised there.
I was.
That was pretty funny.
Easy for you to say.
Okay, now you were... Okay, so...
So, in 1986, the program I do with Roger Mudd is based out of Washington, so I was very excited because I was going to be able to move to
Washington.
Together.
Yeah,
we could live
That would have been the
together.
First time that you had been married that you were actually spending all your
That's
time
That's right.
Together.
It would be a whole new experience. And so, we, I was ready to move my clothes down, except I hadn't had a chance because I was doing so much traveling, covering stories.
Mm-hmm.
And just about a week ago, he called me up and he said, guess what? I'm moving to New York.
Yeah.
He works for, I thought, well, passing in the night. But he works for Fox Television. Rupert Murdoch just bought Metro Media.
Yeah, this is the big deal. They're starting a fourth network and Joan Rivers, and now Maury has a show and so
That's
forth.
That's right.
Yeah.
And it's a 10-week run in the summer in New York. It'll be on at 11:30 in the evening for a half an hour.
Mm. What kind of show is it going to have?
Yeah, he's not sure. I mean, they're working on the format.
Good. That's good.
No, it's a news program. It's a
news
program.
Be a news program.
Sort of
guests?
Nightline. Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Sort of
talk
like Nightline.
News.
Yeah.
Talk news, but they're developing it.
Yeah. Well, that's good. So you'll be together now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, congratulations.
That's why I won't move to Washington.
No, that's nice. We're happy to have you here. Anything
Thank
else?
You.
When's the next 1986 come on? That's like once a month you do one of these?
No, it's once a week.
Once a week.
Every Tuesday night at 10 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. And what's coming up this week?
Well, this week, actually, we have a special on terrorism.
Mm-hmm.
The following week, we'll be back to sort of the regular schedule in which we'll have four stories each.
Yeah. And you do follow-ups? We find out how those kids get out of selling magazines?
Sure. Right. Absolutely.
Is there anything else we ought to cover, Connie, before you're dismissed? Is that about it?
Well, can I tell you about one of the stories I'm doing?
Well, let me see.
Do
let me ask
time?
This man over here. Is that the sign that she has all the time she wants?
No. Oh,
no, I don't
goodbye.
Think so. Yeah, I think
I know,
that's a goodbye.
Yes, it's a goodbye.
You have to come back and tell us about that story.
All right. Really, the stories are very interesting. I hope you can watch.
Yeah. And it did very well, didn't it?
It did. We tied for number one in our time period. So
no, that's good.
It was excellent.
Now it's
and
time
we
to go.
Thank you.
You have
no,
to
we
go
thank
now,
you.
Connie. No, you have to go.
For your
you have
thank
to go
you
now.
For your help.
You go on Maury's show and tell him.
No.
Okay.